Hey everyone, sorry I've been absent, but I do have an update review on the pillows. So my husband still loves 2 weeks later, still loves his Layla pillow. This is the APOC or KPOC, I don't know, the special filling in there, and it is the copper infused lining. So it's got kind of like these copper invisible copper coils somewhere in here, so it keeps you cool at night. He is a hot sleeper, and believe me, he is warm. So if he's happy with this pillow, if you are looking for a pillow that keeps you cool at night, that has the stuffing inside, and if you are a side sleeper that kind of turns on your back just a little bit, but mainly a side sleeper, this is the pillow you want to get. Yes, it's expensive, but you will love it. And if you have, you know, neck pain, shoulder pain, if you wake up stiff in the morning, this is the pillow for you. All right. Now for my pillow. The pillow that I chose, if you haven't seen that video, I chose the Eli and Elm kind of like a boomerang shaped pillow. It did not work out for me. After 2 weeks of trying to fuss with it and adjust it, it still was a little stiff. So what ended up happening is the pillow comes with, of course, not the same fluff, but fluff like that so it can be adjusted. The boomerang, oh, it lost some fluff. The boomerang shape is mainly suitable for side sleeping. The reason why I got it is because the reviewer had said that you could sleep with it on your back and on your side. That is two positions out of the three that I do. Let me explain. I start out on my back, I turn to a side, I turn to a side, I go back to my back, and then I'll end up on my stomach somehow, some way during the night. So I need a pillow that's going to suit all of the sleep positions. And I felt that the Eli and Elm pillow would suit the main positions that I normally switch back and forth to. So I am a combination sleeper, AKA the way I call it is a rotisserie sleeper. So that pillow, the Eli and Elm pillow that I got, really didn't suit my needs. And when we took out a lot of the fluff, it ended up having a soggy kind of like not supportive enough for the middle, which is for my neck area. It didn't support that. And all of the fluff ended up being on the sides of the pillow, which ended up being really, really stiff, which was great when I wanted to turn on my side. But as soon as I wanted to sleep on my back, the support was just not there. So I really don't recommend that pillow, even for side sleepers. My husband tried that pillow out and he said that he did not like sleeping with that pillow. So if you do want to order that pillow, again, you have to have like a really, really firm, you have to like a really, really firm feel to your pillow. And we don't. We like really soft, you know, cushy things. So I really can't recommend that Eli and Elm pillow because we're sending it back. So the pillow that I have recently ordered is the Casper pillow. And I will do a full review once I get it and try it out. Hopefully it's going to be hopefully it'll be the best pillow ever. it is supposed to be a pillow for all around sleeping positions. So it's supposed to work on your belly, your back and your side. So I hope that it's going to be a pillow that's really, really great. If not, I am really considering the Layla pillow because after 2 weeks, it definitely squishes down a lot more. And so this one's well worked in by my husband, thank goodness. And so it actually is a little suitable for back sleeping. When you first get the Layla pillow, it's got a huge loft, and a big loft is not good for back sleeping because it pushes your neck forward at a 45 to 90 degree angle. I'm having neck problems. So when you are sleeping on your back, your nose is supposed to be aligned with the ceiling. And that's with me researching all of the YouTube videos and looking for the best pillow again, searching again for a really good pillow. So the only problem again that I have with the Layla is that I don't know how to clean it. I'm not sure if you're just supposed to spot clean it or throw it in the washer. I'm sure I can find this information all on their website, but it's going to be a real big hassle to take all the fluff out and then stuff it right back in. So, thankfully with the Casper pillow is designed for a pillow within a pillow. Again, I will explain it all as soon as I get the pillow and I will review it in depth. I'm trying not to put the Casper pillow in this review. So this is just an update on the pillow situation. So we'll see about the Casper. The Layla's still good, and I will see you guys next time.